Today, we'll be investigating an amazing career choice.
They help all animals, from our small house pets and animal companions, to the flocks and herds that we use to feed ourselves, to the animals that entertain and amaze us.
Animals can get just as sick as humans, and of course, can't tell you if they have a cold or a fever.
The kind men and women who help animals are called veterinarians and animal health technologists.
Veterinarians are doctors of veterinary medicine. They have chosen to treat animals but know just as much about curing illnesses and disease as your family doctor.
You require good marks coming out of high school, especially in science courses. There are 5 different colleges and universities across Canada for training as a veterinarian.
In Eastern Canada, they are the Atlantic Veterinary College in Prince Edward Island, University of Montreal in Quebec, and the Ontario Veterinary College in Guelph.
And in Western Canada, veterinary medicine is offered in Alberta at the University of Calgary and at the University of Saskatchewan in Saskatoon.
Young veterinary students learn how an animal's body works. They study the diseases and injuries an animal can develop and the signs or symptoms to look for.
Veterinary students also learn how to keep our food supply from cattle, poultry, and swine healthy and safe.
Once a veterinarian is trained and receives his or her Doctor of Veterinary Medicine degree, the choices for work are absolutely unlimited. The field of veterinary medicine is commonly divided into small animal care and large animal care.
Urban veterinarians usually specialize in small animal health care, pets and family companions, like dogs,
cats,
birds,
rabbits,
aquarium fish, and other sorts of house pets. Some of these veterinarians might maintain the health of some very heroic small animal patients.
Some veterinarians specialize in beef medicine. The health and safety of our beef cattle directly affects the health and safety of our food supply.
Their work may take them to huge feedlots where they are responsible for large herds of cattle.
They routinely inspect the herd and make certain they are healthy and well cared for.
Another large animal specialty, dairy medicine. Milk products are a huge percentage of our daily food intake, so the health and safety of our dairy herds is extremely important.
Again, the veterinarians may assist with calving and vaccinations, but they also ensure that all milk is healthy and collected in a clean and safe manner.
Equine care refers to the medical care and attention required by horses.
Alberta has the largest population of horses in Canada. Because of their size and strength, horses can be difficult to treat.
Some horses are ridden for enjoyment. Others work as herd horses used by cowboys and cowgirls. All these horses have veterinarians caring for them.
Still others entertain us as show horses and jumpers, and a few become famous as race horses or chuck wagon race winners. Pig farming is big business in Alberta. Veterinarians visit pig herds regularly to keep the entire herd as healthy as possible.
A disease-free status must be maintained on each and every pig farm. A healthy and safe supply of pork food products all begins with a healthy pig herd.
Chicken and turkey farms require regular visits from veterinarians. They ensure that the eggs and the chicken and turkey meat that goes to market are safe and healthy.
Poultry diseases spread rather easily, so veterinarians make sure the barn environment doesn't become contaminated. Poultry farms must be protected from disease entry. The care and farming of fish is rooted in ancient history, as far back as 2500 BC in China.
Veterinarians who work with fish are known as aquatic veterinarians. They are often hired by fish farms to look after the health of schools or herds of fish.
The need to solve worldwide overfishing of wild fish stocks is one of the main reasons for the growth of aqua farming.
For many decades, hatchery production of young fish to restock lakes, streams, and oceans is a form of aquaculture that has protected endangered wild fish populations.
On a smaller scale, aquarium fish require the care of a veterinarian.
Aquatic veterinarians must be familiar with the basic biology of fish to treat parasites and disease that may infect the school.
Marine veterinarians are closely connected to aquatic veterinarians, but marine medicine is more about the health care of fish and mammals that live wild in the ocean. Their special knowledge is very valuable to the ocean fishing industry and to marine display aquariums and shows.
Veterinarians are required by zoos, national parks, and for research in protecting endangered wildlife species.
Although some of the animals cared for in zoos may be quite unusual, basic medical care is common to all species, including humans.
We all require proper nutrition, exercise, and a stimulating yet familiar environment for us to feel safe and secure.
Veterinarians are required for research on conservation and the effects of environmental change on animals and animal behavior.
Reptiles, exotic birds, and exotic fish are now becoming popular pets. Veterinarians are constantly studying to provide the best medical care for rare and exotic species.
And from an agricultural perspective, ostrich, llama, and elk farms are growing in numbers, requiring veterinarians to maintain healthy, exotic animal flocks and herds.
The detection and tracking of diseases in animals is very demanding and specialized. Sadly, if an animal dies, veterinarians often need to figure out why the animal became sick, so they can protect the rest of the herd or flock from the same disease.
Animal pathology is the study of why an animal has died, and it is becoming more and more important as we discover that certain viruses and diseases mutate and cross over to humans. Veterinary pathologists and epidemiologists study how some diseases over time can pass from animals to humans. You may have heard about this with the bird or avian flu, mad cow disease, and other diseases such as rabies. Zoonotic medicine is the study of these diseases.
For this reason, many veterinarians work in the area of human health, both in Alberta and on a federal level across Canada.
Many veterinarians also look after the health, care, and safety of animals used in the testing of new life-saving drugs and medicines.
Veterinarians are required to ensure a healthy food supply. They are employed by the government as food and health inspectors.
They make sure that imported and exported foods and animals are safe and healthy. It's considered a very important part of border security. We wouldn't want people poisoned by live animals or tainted food that is being imported or exported out of Canada.
Throughout history, mankind has wanted to heal the animals that share their lives.
The original veterinarians worked on horse injuries and illnesses in order to keep the armies of Rome and later the great Napoleonic forces on the move.
The mighty engine for these armies right up to World War I was horsepower, and it was important to keep the horses healthy.
The first veterinary school was opened in Lyon, France in the mid-18th century.
The Ontario Veterinary College in Guelph, Ontario, founded in 1862, is often considered the oldest veterinary training facility in North America.
The Alberta Veterinary Medical Association, or ABVMA, regulates the practice of veterinary medicine in Alberta and is well over 100 years old.
The ABVMA ensures all veterinarians perform their duties in a skillful and professional manner and provides regular inspection of veterinary facilities, as well as ongoing training and education.
You can also work in animal health care, aiding a veterinarian as a registered animal health technologist. It takes 2 years of study to become an AHT.
In Alberta, there are four colleges that offer this course: Olds College, Fairview College, Lakeland College, and the Northern Alberta Institute of Technology in Edmonton.
Thanks for watching.
And good luck with your career.